Welcome back to our Baselworld Trend Report for 2018. The previous trend we spotted is the overwhelming presence of retro vintage watches and reissued historical timepieces. One company that's betting big on its past is Breitling, the brand behind the legendary Navi Timer watch, the world's first self-winding chronograph.
This is Breitling's first Baselworld exhibition under the leadership of their new CEO, George Kern, who was formerly with IWC. And this watch, the Navi Timer 8, is their first watch under the new leadership. And just by looking at it, you know, change is coming.
The new Navi Timer 8 collection of chronographs, unitimers, and automatic date and day-date models are a departure from the existing Navi Timer Pilot watch. They're all handsome indeed, but very different without the oversized case and the busy dial with slide rule we are familiar with. Even the logo, the flying bee, has lost its wings. Breitling clarifies that Navi Timer 8 will not replace the existing Navi Timer in the model lineup, but a new design, which is heavily influenced by Breitling's early years, is a taste of watches yet to come.
One of the things that we've done is taken away the wings logo, which automatically gives us a stronger connection with these Willy Breitling years, which had the B Breitling logo. Basically, what we've done is worked on colors, we've cleaned up what's on the dial, and it's made the watch, in my opinion, has gone from being a pilot's watch, maybe influenced by the 80s and 90s, to something which is automatically influenced by the early Navi Timer years, which to many people in the market who would not have bought a Breitling, all of a sudden they can see the watch maybe more like I do, which is a very elegant 1950s watch.
With the uncluttered design, Bovet is actually bringing the Navi Timer closer to its pre-1960s heritage, when it was known as a sleek but practical timepiece worn by cool people rather than a chunky pilot watch.
What I see is a tool watch which is amazingly well designed. I mean, talking about the length of the lines and the dials, the proportions of the horns and everything, they're tool watches which are beautiful enough to be evening watches. And that, I think, is something unique. When you look at the Breitling watches, you look at them and you're like, wow, there's really a lot to look at there that we could, that we could be inspired by.
In fact, the Navi Timer 8 collection reminds me of the pre-60s Breitlings, which are currently the holy grail of collectors. The line is top-billed by the flagship BO1 chronograph, using an in-house caliber in a choice of red gold or steel. The pre-existing Navi Timer has been reinvented as a Navi Timer 1, and with a smaller 38mm case variant of the Pilot watch, available with a cleaner dial. It reflects another trend at Baselworld, wherein watches with extra large cases and blinged out dials are being toned down and downsized. You know the trend is real when Hublot, a luxury brand known for its outsized watches, starts offering its iconic 45mm Big Bang Unico model in a pared-down 42mm case that looks more elegant on the wrist, even as it keeps that unmistakable Hublot appeal. The case isn't just smaller, but slimmer, and Hublot had to craft a new movement to make it fit. Breguet is hardly ever associated with oversized pieces, but their previous marine models, their version of a waterproof sports watch, were a bit heavy and large for a brand better known for slim cases and classic designs. Two-thirds of this year's line of handcrafted marine timepieces, the 5517 self-winding watch and the 5447 alarm musicale, are offered in a more appropriately sized 14mm case in either titanium with a gray sunburst dial or white or red gold with a navy hand guilloche dial. It's not exactly clear what's driving the trend in smaller, slimmer watches. Surely, the revived interest in vintage and blings falling out of fashion should have something to do with it. Speaking of bling and fashion, up until recently, most ladies' watches were conceptualized and marketed as fashion and jewelry pieces first, serious timekeeping instruments second. But that's changing as the number of timepieces with mechanical movements and complications continues to grow at Baselworld. One brand in particular shows us just how fast and far ladies' watches have come in the past quarter of a century.
...2018 is a very special year for Chopard. It's a 25th year anniversary of one of their most iconic, if not the most iconic watch in the modern era, which is the Happy Sport. And here we have some really beautiful pieces.
Happy Sport, with its playful dancing gems on the dial, is Chopard's best-selling watch. Introduced in 1993 with diamonds in a stainless steel case and a battery-powered quartz movement, the model has since evolved into something more spectacular, not just in the choice of gems, dial designs, and precious metals, but also in the quality of movements offered. By 2013, a mechanical self-winding movement was in place. That same year, a Happy Sport with tourbillon and 30 diamonds on its bridge was presented. Though the 308 diamonds on the dial was a scene stealer, some ladies took note of the tourbillon crafted by Chopard's elite LUC manufacturer. In 2018, its silver anniversary, the Happy Sport shows up in a variety of whimsical yet elegant handcrafted dials.
The snowflake really represents what the Happy Sport is about. It's happy, it's playful, it's joyful. It's like having winter inside your watch case.
Another highlight is a happy palm, celebrating Chopard's partnership with the Cannes Film Festival.
And this one is the happy fish. It's a fish, so it's water resistant as well. But of course, it's much more than that. This is a really beautiful way of crafting a dial. Just take a look at the details. The Happy Sport also comes in a smaller case size, 30 millimeters. It also has, for the first time in a Happy Sport, an in-house Chopard caliber.
Chopard proves a bejeweled feminine watch deserves a top-notch mechanical movement. Rolex agrees. One of their most talked about pieces was a Rolex Cosmograph Daytona in Everose Gold, with 36 rainbow-colored sapphires on the bezel. A fashionable watch, yes, but equipped with a state-of-the-art Rolex 4130 chronograph caliber. Not to be outdone is Patek Philippe. The company has been making top-caliber clocks and watches for queens and empresses as far back as the 19th century. And the current owners, the Stern family, continues the tradition.
As usual, there are many beautiful ladies' watches in this year's Baselworld show, but what really sets Patek Philippe's watches apart from the rest is the details. Details you hardly even notice unless you use a loupe or really look up close or own one. And in this case, this lady's chronograph, it's the glass box, sapphire crystal glass.
Never mind the 72 diamonds and rose gold bezel of the reference 7150. That's a flourish. The main attraction is a hand-wound chronograph movement, impeccable craftsmanship, and tasteful application of vintage elements.
So, vintage style in terms of the lugs, the style of pushers, the style of the dial, where you have the Brugge style numerals and hands, all in rose gold. We also have a pulsimeter scale. And what is really particular about this watch is the box sapphire crystal glass.
The gently domed box sapphire crystal in the front and the back isn't just about channeling vintage style. It's a technical achievement too.
It lets in more light, and that just changes everything, right? When you're holding it.
And that's the objective of the Stern families, to differentiate the brand by this knowledge and the mastering of not only the movement, but case making, dial making, by adding up all these little details that make it so, well, challenging and also costly. Mm-hmm. But we only have to present results to their own family. Mm-hmm. So it's the cost in development is not a question.
If you remember our Baselworld coverage in 2015, this watch was quite controversial, the Calatrava Pilot Travel Time watch. It was, at least back then, love it or hate it. But right now, it's all about love. It's a long, long love affair with this watch. And that's why it appears again in 2018.
And this time in a 37.5mm case that's perfect for a lady's wrist. The reference 7234 is a serious complication. A robust travel time movement wants to serve for men. This is Patek's first time to offer the same movement, case and dial, in two sizes. But they're not identical. The ladies' version is subtly feminine, with a different gold tone, not just a downsized men's watch.
But in the end, for us, the limit is elegance. So if technically it's not possible to create an elegant ladies' watch,
you know,
aesthetic and elegant, we will not create it. That's the limit.
When it comes to ladies' watches, it's impossible not to include one other elite watchmaker, which, like Patek, has been crafting delicate timepieces for famous queens in history.
Breguet is a leader when it comes to ladies' watches with complications. And the great thing about the brand is they don't just reduce the size of a men's watch and call it a ladies' watch. No, these watches are purpose-built for sophisticated women who enjoy and appreciate watchmaking technology.
None more so than the Reine de Naples watch. Named after Napoleon's sister, Caroline, the Queen of Naples, who commissioned watches from Abraham Louis Breguet. Underneath a feminine mother of pearl and white gold dial with 128 diamonds on the gold bezel is a complex in-house self-winding movement that enables the power reserve and moon phase indications.
It's hard to tell them apart, but imagine, this original Queen of Naples watch was created in 2002. It's now 2018. It still looks so beautiful.
The 2000 edition is an update of the first Reine de Naples introduced 16 years ago. A young collection, yet already Breguet's most iconic ladies' watch. And one of the many new models at Baselworld that female watch complication enthusiasts can enjoy. That's 5 out of 10 trends we spotted at Baselworld. For the next 5, we'll focus on innovations and creativity. Plus, our list of favorite timepieces of the fair on the next episode of Executive Class.
Join us again next time for the second part of our coverage of Baselworld 2018. Till then, I'm David Celdran. Thanks for watching.